हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम राखी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट IIMT कॉलेज ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक कोरिलेशन एनालिसिस एंड इट्स मेथड। बिफोर गोइंग टू द टॉपिक, आई वांट टू शो माय टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट। दिस बेसिकली इज माय टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट एंड ऑल द टॉपिक मेंशन हियर आई विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल वन बाय वन। मीनिंग ऑफ कोरिलेशन, यूजेस एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ कोरिलेशन, टाइप्स ऑफ कोरिलेशन, डिग्री ऑफ कोरिलेशन एंड मेथड्स ऑफ कोरिलेशन। लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक विद मीनिंग ऑफ कोरिलेशन। एज द नेम सजेस्ट, कोरिलेशन इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू वर्ड्स, को दैट मीन्स टुगेदरनेस एंड रिलेशन दैट मीन्स कनेक्शन और एसोसिएशन बिटवीन द टू वेरिएबल्स और टू क्वांटिटी। कोरिलेशन एनालिसिस इज द स्टेटिस्टिकल टूल दैट इज यूज टू फाइंड आउट द डिग्री ऑफ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू वेरिएबल्स as well as directions of the variables. As we know, price and demand both are inversely related, right? If the price increases, demand decreases. If the price decreases, demand increases. But with the help of correlation analysis tool, we get to know to what extent both the variables are related to each other in one numerical value. And this numerical value is called coefficient of correlation. To measure the degree of association or relationship between the two variables quantitatively, an index of relationship is used here that is termed as coefficient of correlation. The range of coefficient of correlation is in between -1 to +1. The plus and minus sign indicate the directions of the variables and the numerical value indicate the degree of the relationship between the two variables. One thing is important here to know, correlation fail to tell us the causation effect. That means correlation does not tell the cause and effect relationship of the variables. Correlation merely tells about the linear relationship between the two variables only. Come on to the next slide, that is uses and significance of correlation analysis. First use of the correlation analysis, that is it helpful in measuring the degree of relationship between the two variables. Next, it's helpful in regression analysis. Regression in analysis is another statistical tool that is used to find out the value of one variable on the basis of given value of another variable. Regression analysis totally depend on the correlation analysis. When one is very clear about the relationship between the two variables, then only he can predict the value of one variable on the basis of given value of another variable. One variable which is to be predicted and another variable on the basis of which the value of other variable is to be predicted, both the variables should have some kind of relationship. Only then one can predict the value of one variable on the basis of given value of another variable. So we can say regression analysis totally depend on the correlation analysis. Next, the study of correlation is very useful to the economics. Economics use the correlation analysis to find out the relation of the economic variable like price, demand, etc. Coefficient of correlation is a relative measure. That means it is independent from the measuring unit of the variable. Helpful in determining the probable error and sampling error. Come on to the next slide, that is types of correlation. Correlation, we can classify it broadly into the three parts, positive and negative correlation, which is totally based on the directions of the variables. Linear and non-linear correlation, which is based on the changing proportions of the variable. Simple, multiple and partial correlation, which is based on the number of the variables under study. Let's come on to the next slide. On the basis of direction of correlation, we can classify the correlation into the two parts, negative correlation, positive correlation. Positive correlation, if both the variables move in same direction, then we can say both the variables have positive correlation. If one variable increases, other variable will also be increases. If one variable decreases, other variable will also be decreases. For example, price and supply of the commodity. If price increases, supply will also be increases. If price decreases, supply will also be decreases. Then we can say price and supply of the commodity have positive correlation. Negative correlation, when both the variables move in opposite direction, Then we can say both the variables have negative correlation. If one variable increase, other variable will decrease. If one variable decrease, other variable will increase. For example, price and demand of the commodity. Come on to the next slide. That is, on the basis of variables under study, correlation can be classified into the three parts: simple correlation, partial correlation, and multiple correlation. Simple correlation is a case when you have only two variables under study and you try to find out the relationship between these two variables. Then we can say both the variables have simple correlation. For example, if you want to find out the relationship between the height and weight, price and demand, income and consumption, these are the example of simple correlation. Partial and multiple correlation are the case where you have more than two variables. If you have three and more variables, then you are then the case of partial correlation and multiple correlation. Partial correlation, when you have more than two variables, suppose you have three variables but you try to find out the relationship, relationship between the two variables, and third variable you consider the constant, it is the case of partial correlation. Multiple correlation, when you have more than three variables or more variables under study and you try to find out the relationship between all of these. Come on to the next slide. That is, basis of the proportion, correlation can be classified into the two parts: linear correlation and non-linear correlation. Linear correlation, when the change in one variable followed by the change in another variable in constant ratio, it is a case of linear correlation. Non-linear correlation, when change in one variable does not follow constant ratio with the change in another variable, it is a case of non-linear or curvilinear correlation. Come on to the next slide. That is, properties of correlation. The correlation coefficient, which is denoted by the small r, lies between minus 1 to plus 1. The plus and minus sign indicate the directions of the variable and the numerical value indicate the degree of the relationship between the variables. Correlation coefficient r is a pure number. That means it is independent of the unit of measurement of the variable. The correlation coefficient r is independent of change of origin. Independent of change of origin, that means if the individual value of the variable x or y is increased or decreased by any constant, the value of the coefficient of correlation will remain be same as it is calculated from the original data. Next, correlation coefficient r is independent of change in scale. That means if the individual value of the x variable and y variable are multiplied or divided by any constant, the value of the coefficient of correlation r will remain the same as it is calculated from the original data. Next, degree of the correlation. Degree of the correlation totally based on the value of the coefficient of correlation. We can classify the degree into the five parts: perfect correlation, high degree of correlation, moderate degree of correlation, low degree of correlation, and absence of correlation. Perfect correlation, if the value of the coefficient of correlation exact one, then we can say both the variables have perfect correlation. But if the value of the coefficient of correlation is in minus, we can say both the variables have perfect negative correlation. If the value of the coefficient of correlation is in minus, then if we can say both the variables have perfect negative correlation. Next, high degree of correlation. If the value of the coefficient of correlation lies between the range 0.75 to 1. But if the value is in plus between this range, we can say both the variables have high degree positive correlation. But if the value is in minus between this range, we can say both the variables have high degree negative correlation. Next, moderate degree of correlation. If the value of the coefficient of correlation lies between 0.25 to 0.75. But if the value is in plus between this range, we can say both the variables have high degree of positive correlation. But if the value is in minus between this range, we can say both the variables have moderate degree of negative correlation. Next, low degree of correlation. If the value of the coefficient of correlation lies between 0.25 to 0, It is a case of low degree correlation. But if the value is in plus between this range, we can say low degree of positive correlation. But if the value of the coefficient of correlation between these range is in minus, we can say both the variables have low degree negative correlation. Absence of correlation, when there is no relationship between the variables and the value of the coefficient, will be zero in this case. Come on to the next slide, that is methods of correlation. We can find out the degree of relationship between the two variables with the help of these methods. There are the five methods to find out the degree of relationship: scatter diagram method, graphic method, Karl-Pearson coefficient of correlation method, Spearman rank coefficient of correlation method, and last one is coefficient of concurrent deviation method. First one, scatter diagram method, that is very simplest method to study the correlation between the two variables, wherein the value for each pair of the variable is plotted on the graph. In this method, we simply plot the value of the variable on the graph paper by putting the dots. And after that, we get the scatter diagram like this. But some points we should have to keep in mind to interpret the scatter diagram. If all the dots lie in one straight line and this straight line showing the upward trend, we can say both the variables have strong positive correlation as shown in the first diagram. If all the dots lies in one straight line and the line showing the downward trend, then we can say both the variables have strong negative correlation. If all the variables are scattered from each other and showing upward trend, then we can say both the variables have weak positive correlation. If all the points are scattered from each other and showing downward trend, then we can say both the variables have weak negative correlation. If all the variables are very close to each other, we can say both the variables have very strong correlation. And if all the dots showing no trend, then we can say both the variables have no correlation as shown in the last diagram. Next, Karl-Pearson coefficient of correlation, which is very widely used mathematical method, wherein the numerical expression is used to calculate the degree and direction of the relationship between the linear related variable. Pearson method is based on the mean and standard deviation. And the formula is used to find out the degree of relationship between the two variables. Next, change of origin and change in scale I have already discussed. If we either add or subtract any digit in the x variable or y variable and compute the coefficient of correlation from the revised data, it will be same in the case of change of origin. And change in scale, it is independent from the change in scale. If we either divide or multiply x and y variable by any digit or any constant and compute the correlation coefficient, answer will remain the same. The last one, Spearman rank correlation. Spearman rank correlation is another method to find out the value or degree of relationship between the two qualitative variables. That means Spearman rank correlation is used to find out the degree of correlation between the qualitative variables, not quantitative variables, such as judgment, beauty, honesty, leadership, taste. In this method, ranks are given to you. If the ranks are not given, then the variable are assigned rank either in ascending or descending order to their size. And the formula is used to find out the degree of relationship between the qualitative variables. R indicate the rank coefficient of correlation, capital R. And the D indicate the difference between the rank. This is the end of the video. Thank you.